Happy New Year and welcome to 2024, which in this household we have literally crashed right into. For lots of people, January means giving things up. Meat, booze, sugar. Some of you, the first Friday of the month, are going to be really feeling it, thirsting for the one thing that you've denied yourself. Well, I may have good news for you, because we know that 91% of New Year's resolutions fail. So instead, what should we be thinking about? I've got Dory Clark on the vlog to talk about The Long Game, her book, about how we might approach this differently. She starts by sharing her take on the dangers of short-term thinking.
The default is to do what is right in front of you. Answer the email, get the thing taken care of. And it's not that that's bad, but the problem is that if we only do short-term things over and over again, you just end up in a random place rather than the place that perhaps you were most hoping to go to. Amazon, of course, is much larger, much more successful, much more ubiquitous today than it was in 2011. But even then, it was a force. They asked, you know, so Jeff Bezos, why is Amazon so successful? And his answer was that Amazon relies on a 7-year planning cycle. They would be strategically patient enough for a new product or a new service to take 7 years to achieve profitability. Amazon Web Services or Amazon Prime were not things that necessarily seemed so big at the time, but they've become a crucial part of the ecosystem because Amazon was willing to keep investing and not necessarily drive immediate profit.
She goes on to share a great question that I think we should all think about.
It's important to recognize that short-term willpower is not necessarily the answer for your life. What makes something a lot more intrinsically motivating is understanding and asking yourself, where do I want to be in the future? And in fact, even more saliently, who do I want to be in the future?
And then talks about the time frame in which she thinks about her progress.
You can figure out a lot of things in 10 years. All you need to know is what is the end goal and then what is the next step that you're doing. So for instance, I am in the midst of a cycle right now that I started in 2016. My 10-year plan was to learn to write from scratch musical theater. My goal was to write a show that could make it to Broadway. And so I'm now in year 7 of this. I haven't yet written a show that has made it to Broadway, but I have written 2 complete musicals. I've had one workshopped in Sweden. I have had a staged reading at an off-Broadway theater. I have actually made really tremendous progress. And by having a goal, it enables us to just kind of keep moving toward that.
Next week, I'm going to be sharing my 10-year planning, boom, mind blown, to 2034. Can hardly even say the words. Would love to know your take on whether that's realistic, whether it's exciting, whether it's too terrifying. Do like or comment if you enjoyed this, and do sign up for the newsletter if you want to stay engaged with what we're doing in 2024. See you next Friday. Shot away, I am not throwing away my shot.